guys.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I loved Far From the Tree. It was so sweet and reminded me of my mother. So,
Yay, thank
yes.
you.
Natalie, I saw this was inspired by the art of Manu Arenas. Was there any specific piece that inspired you, or would you say it was just the art style or the narrative that you really took from it?
When I came to Disney, I had the office kitty corner to Manu Arenas, and I freaked out. I was so scared. I tried not to like see him in the hallway for weeks because I was a fan. I had his comic Yaxine when I was working at Helioscope in Portland, and it was my first Euro comic. I just love the art style, and eventually over time, I found found the words to go and introduce myself, and Manu became a friend. So working with him on this project and getting to say, I love this. Can we try and do this in a Disney movie was so exciting.
Oh, I love that. Now, Ruth, I believe this is your first time really working as a producer, rather than like a specific subset of
Yeah.
manager or supervisor. What has that experience been like for you? And how early on in the process did you jump on board?
Great question. So Natalie and I had worked together on Ralph Breaks the Internet, where she was a story artist and I was the production supervisor for story. So we already had a really great working relationship, which is super important for a producer and director in a film. And on a film, you have more time to, you know, on a feature, there's a lot of time to build that trust. But because we already had that, we kind of started ahead of the curve, which was awesome. So she, I think, was asked to direct at the end of 2018. And then very soon after that, at the beginning of 2019, I was asked to produce, which I absolutely jumped at because I knew from experience what an amazing creative talent Natalie is and what her work ethic is like, and that it would be just the best experience ever to be able to produce a film with her. So I learned a lot because, as you said, it was my first time. I feel like I'd sat in rooms with so many exceptional producers over the course of my career that I learned a lot just watching them and watching them ask the right questions, watching them know when to step in and when to just let things go, and watching the strategy that they brought to a project. So I think I was very fortunate to have been able to learn by osmosis and then jump in and have a go. And I think we did a good job in the end.
Yeah, I love that. It feels very collaborative. And I know that Natalie, you previously did the short circuit program. So it does really feel like these things carry over and help you learn your way, if you will. But one thing I really loved was how there was easily room for just like the anthropomorphic, just like literally dialogue or just, you know, have jokes included in there. And yet the emotion really came through just with animal noises, you know, like I didn't need to hear them speak. How was that decision made and why was it made, though it was correct?
Thank you. I'm glad that it came across and you felt that way. I think I always wanted it to be without dialogue. It just feels like with shorts, ideally, you want to touch as many people as possible with the story. You want as many people as possible to walk out of it understanding the emotion. And, you know, my husband is French. I majored in Japanese in college. I really love the idea of being able to walk into a theater with people at a film festival who don't speak English, and we can all walk out and make eye contact and be like, yeah, we all felt that, right? You know, like it makes you feel close to people and it's so universal. You know, we tried some versions where they talk with each other with the raccoon noises, but the more we pulled back, the better it felt. So in the end, less was more.
We really did experiment a lot. Some of the boards, they're a lot more anthropomorphic and doing human-like activities. And we kind of went back both ways. And then we brought in a voice actor to see if we could have someone mimic the raccoon noises in a way that sounded more like talking. But at the end of the day, raccoons are so funny anyway, just in their natural habitat, that we realized we just had to lean on the way they naturally act, and that would give us what we needed.
I love that so much. And does that, when you guys are looking for how you're going to, I guess, work the sound design, if you will, right now that you've decided we're going to do this more like realistic approach to it, less is more, how do you choose the right sounds or the right atmospheric as well as animal?
You pair up with an expert. So we got to work with Laurent Cossayon, who is an amazing sound designer, and he met with us and consulted and said, I think this is the right way to go for the raccoon noises. I think this is how hard we should push the beach noises and when to phase things in and out. So he did a wonderful job. I think he really went out and collected some of these animal sounds on his own, like with a microphone. So we're so impressed with what he brought back.
I love that. Oh, there you go. That adds to both the realism and then like that feeling of family. Now, Ruth, Disney is very known for, you know, dead or disappeared parents. So it's somewhat unusual to get to really enjoy complicated parent-child dynamics. Can you talk about approaching the story from that angle?
Well, you know, we did in technically the senior raccoon does pass away in the middle of the film. So we did, you know, we talked about whether we should have some kind of death scene for him, but felt like everyone would get it at the end. So we really wanted, and you know, Natalie can speak more to this, but we started out with human characters and that seemed incredibly morbid to be talking about generations across 7 minutes. So when they turned into raccoons, it was a lot easier, but we really had wanted to talk to this theme of parenting, because even if you're not a parent, everyone has parents in some form or another. So everyone understands and sees themselves. It's so cool to hear that you saw your parents, your mother in this movie, because so many people say, wow, that's my story. Like I totally do that to my kid, or my parent did that to me. And it really is it's really humbling how it's transcended across cultures and generations and people seeing themselves. It's really, really cool.
Definitely. Now that you said that it was originally human characters, which I would not have thought, that makes me more interested in the title, Far From the Tree. At what point, Natalie, did this title come into play? And then how literal did you want to be? Because for a while I was like, I don't see the tree. And I was like, I get it now.
I'm terrified by the idea of coming up with titles. I put it off. I'm not good at coming up with titles. And thank goodness we had a whole team to help me out. So I think Ruth and I spent months like with a list of possible ideas. We sent out, you know, an anonymous form to our whole crew so everyone could contribute ideas. And as soon as we saw Far From the Tree, I think we were like, you know, circling around that one, like, that's it, you know. They're raccoons, they're in a tree, because by then we were pretty near the end of production. It speaks to the theme of, you know, can you do things differently than your parent? Are you doomed to follow in their footsteps? Is it possible to try something new? And is it such a bad thing to understand where they were coming from?
Right. I'd love so many complicated emotions in such few short moments. I know that Disney is, you know, likes to keep a lid on everything all the time, but what can you guys say about what you are each working on next?
Well, it's been announced. Iwaju is a collaboration between Disney and Kugali Media, and I'm serving as head of story on that, which is really exciting.
I love that.
And then I am also, I can talk because it's been announced, working on a project for Disney Plus, which is Zootopia themed, which explores some of the other characters in the world of Zootopia, which is super fun because Zootopia was the first feature that I worked on at the studio. So I am very excited to be delving back into that world.
I love that. You are obviously very well equipped to humanize animals. So thank you both
thank
so
you.
Much. It was so much fun to watch.
Thank you.
Have a great day.